Okay, so welcome. Today, ang pag-usapan natin is about operations on functions. Like numbers, functions can be added, subtracted, multiplied, and divided. Except-pointed na denominator is 0 to produce new functions. Bakit bawal mag-divide ng 0? Because it will become undefined. Okay? If f and g are functions, then for every x in the domain or yung mga inputs natin, of both the functions f and g, so x is an element of the domain of f intersection with the domain of g. So we have the following rules. First, the sum rule. The sum of the function f plus g of x, okay, so yung total ng function is equal to function of x plus g of x. So we can just get the value of the functions, then add them para makuha natin kung ano yung kinukuhang sum ng functions. Okay? Then, difference rule, same as the sum rule, f minus g of x is equal to f of x minus g of x. Product rule, f times g of x is equal to f of x times g of x. Quotient rule, f over g of x is equal to f of x over g of x, where g of x is not equal to 0 since division by 0 is undefined. And we have a constant multiple rule. Okay, so if we have a constant c, c times f of x is equal to c times the f of x. Okay, and we have a composite function, f og of x, which is the same with f of g of x. Meaning, ang input ng f ay actually yung values ng g of x. And the input of g is x. Okay? So example, if f of x is equal to x minus 1 and g of x is x squared minus 4x plus 3, let's combine these functions by using sum rule. F plus g of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. Since we know that f of x is equal to x minus 1, we can add it with g of x, which is x squared minus 4x plus 3. Then, removing the grouping symbol, so we have x minus 1 plus x squared minus 4x plus 3. Then, rearranging terms or combining similar terms, we have x squared plus x minus 4x, so pinagsama na natin yung dalawang variable na x lang, and constants. So we have plus 3 minus 1. Then performing operations, combining similar terms, x squared plus x minus 4x, ito ay equal to negative 3 since positive 1 minus 4. Then 3 minus 1 is positive 2. Okay, so now the sum of the function is x squared minus 3x plus 2. And using the difference rule, f of minus g of x is equal to f of x minus g of x. So we have x minus 1 minus x squared minus 4x plus 3. So we have f of x and g of x. Removing the grouping symbols, okay, x minus 1. So dito, change the sign when negative ang nasa unahan ng grouping symbol. So we have from positive x squared, we have negative x squared. From negative 4x, we have positive 4x. Positive 3 magiging negative 3. Then, rearrange the terms para magdikit yung mga similar terms. Okay? So, negative x squared plus x plus 4 plus 4x plus minus 3 plus minus 1. Okay? Now, combine similar terms. We have 5x and negative 4. Okay. How about the product rule? We have f times g of x. So f of x times g of x is x minus 1 times x squared minus 4x plus 3. So dito, ang gagawin natin is distribute natin bawat terms. Okay? So yung x, i-distribute natin sa second factor. We have x times x squared minus 4x plus 3 minus 1. So 1 times x squared minus 4x plus 3. Okay? Then distribute So we have this x cubed minus 4x squared plus 3x minus x squared plus 4x minus 3. Since negative 1 yun, mag-change ng signs ng mga tao. Then, combine similar terms, x cubed minus 5x squared because negative 4x minus x squared, so negative 5. Then, positive 3x plus 4x, we have 7x. Then, constant minus 3. So, that's it. Then, quotient rule, if we have g over f of x, g of x over f of x is the same with x squared minus 4x plus 3 over x minus 1. Now, for finding a quotient, we can factor one of them, then find a common factor na pwede nating i-cancel. So, the numerator is factorable with the factors x minus 1 times x plus x minus 3. So, we have the denominator x minus 1, so we can cancel this 2. So, x minus 3 na lang yung ating answer. Okay? And if we have a composite function f of g of x, so meaning ang outer function natin is f and the inner function is gx, okay, substituting yung input natin which is g of x, so that is x squared minus 4x plus 3, and may function pa tayo sa labas na f, then performing the function of x, x minus 1, so meaning the input would be subtracted by 1, so we have the g of x minus 1. Okay, then removing the grouping symbol, then combining similar terms. Pagpalitin natin yung position, we have g of x. So, meaning ang outer function na natin dito is g and inner function is f. So, we have g of x minus 1. Then, g is x squared minus 4x plus 3. So, lahat ng x natin dito ay papalitan natin ng input na x minus 1. So, we have x minus 1 squared. So, we have x squared minus 4x minus 1. So, we have 4x plus 3. Now, simplify. Expand the binomial. So, x squared minus 2x plus 1 minus 4x plus 4. I distribute this. Then, plus 3. Combining similar terms. Rearranging, then combining similar terms, we have this following answer. So, magkaiba yung answer nila. So, pag nagkaiba yung position nito, iba din yung answers. Okay? So, they are different. Okay? Then, we have shifting, scaling, and reflecting a graph of functions. Shifting or moving a graph of a function. Okay? So, meron tayong vertical shift. Y is equal to f of x plus k. Okay? So, imu-move niya yung graph upward by k units if yung k ay positive or greater than 0. And yung graph naman ay mag-shift downward by k units if k is negative. We have, for example, if the original equation or function is y is equal to x squared. So, if we add plus 1, so we have plus k here, plus 1, we will move one unit upward. Okay? If plus 2, we have moved two units away from the origin or the original position of the graph. Kapag negative naman yung idadagdag sa original function, minus 2 meaning two units move downward. Okay? Then meron tayong horizontal shift or movement horizontally. Y is equal to f of x plus h. So, dun sa vertical shift, meron tayo, the function is i-add natin yung value niya by k units. But, in the horizontal shift, yung input ang dadagdagan natin ng constant. So, ito ay, i-move niya yung graph to the left by h units if h is positive. And to the right, if h is negative. So, if the original function is y is equal to x squared, okay, pag nag-move tayo dito, we add positive constant to x. Okay? So, nag-add tayo ng positive 3 dun sa x. So, nag-move siya to the left. Okay? If yung h is positive, so positive 3, so nag-move siya ng 3 units to the left. If we subtract or add negative constant, like negative 2, dun sa x, mag-move tayo ng 2 units to the right. Okay? Then, scaling of the graph of a function. So, meron tayong vertical scaling. For c is greater than 1, the graph is scaled. So, y is equal to constant multiple c times the function f of x. Okay? It stretches the graph by a factor of c. So, ang factor natin is c. So, ini-stretch niya yung graph by a factor of c. Dito naman, we have y is equal to 1 over c f of x. So, ang factor natin is 1 over c. It compresses naman the graph by a factor of c. Okay? So, kapag naka-constant multiple, it stretches. Kapag reciprocal or denominator, i-divide natin yung function by constant c, it compresses the graph. Example, so we have y is equal to square root of x. If we multiply 3 dun sa function, it stretches the graph vertically. Kapag nag-divide tayo ng 3, pa-compress niya pababa. Horizontal scaling, if c is positive, then mag-multiply tayo dun mismo sa x naman. It stretches the graph by a factor of c, horizontal. If nag-divide tayo sa x ng c, it compresses the graph by a factor of c. So, move naman siya ng horizontal. So, magkocompress siya, papunta sa y-axis, and this one stretches away from the y-axis. Okay, so 3x, ang original ay square root of x, then dito naman, yung x dinivide natin ng 3. So, it stretches. Reflecting the graph of a function. For c is equal to negative 1, the graph is reflected. So, if the constant na ilalagay natin is negative, dun sa mismong function, this reflects the graph of f across the x-axis. If y is equal to f of negative x, so sa x naman tayo naglagay ng negative, it reflects the graph across the y-axis. So, the original function is y is equal to square root of x. If we add negative dun sa x, if we multiply negative sa x, it reflects to across the y-axis. If we multiply the function with negative, so magre-reflect siya across the x-axis. So, ang pinaka-mirror natin dito is the axis. Okay, and that's all for today.